Our universe presents a number of great mysteries that to this day confound a full understanding of it. It was once thought that we see all of the universe in the form of normal matter and energy. The ancient Greeks even had the concept of the atom, but were unaware of the cause of other things. Imagine their surprise today, with their understanding of lightning bolts being the weapons of the gods, where today we have harnessed the power of the electron. But as our understanding of the universe grew, we learned that there were other forms of matter and energy that were not normal, such as antimatter, which we can now create, but there wasn't much of a conception of it until Paul Dirac proposed it in 1928. Though in fairness, some abandoned theories that predate that had something like the concept of antimatter. In its actual context, it's the opposite matter, with flipped charges, and has the property of annihilating when it comes into contact with normal matter in a titanic release of energy. Another indicator of some kind of other matter came in the form of misbehaving galaxies. We found that galaxies should fly apart. The matter we see in them is not of sufficient mass to hold the state of affairs together, leading to a number of hypotheses regarding just what was providing the gravity. After accounting for all normal matter in those galaxies, nothing added up, not even close, leading to the eventual invocation of dark matter, a substance that interacts gravitationally with everything, but not in any other easily detectable way. Interestingly, it's possible that this idea might be erroneous or situational in some way, as there have been indicators of galaxies that have no dark matter, which is an open problem. Dark matter is strange stuff as a result. It passes easily through walls and essentially behaves like a ghost, but this is not unheard of, in that a particle we do know the nature of, the neutrino, also does this. They can pass through entire planets without interaction, but occasionally, they can make a direct hit on another particle and be detected, albeit with much chance and a lot of difficulty. Searches for dark matter in this way have so far turned up nothing, however. Whatever it is, it's apparently different from the neutrino in this regard. Even further, but potentially related, is dark energy, driving the expansion of the universe in an accelerating manner, which may or may not have anything to do with dark matter. So these strange forms of matter and energy in the universe do not quite mesh with what we know about the standard ideas about the Big Bang. We still know so little that we don't know how this state of affairs came to be. But one novel hypothesis that is testable, we'll probably know the answer to this question over the next few years, could add an entire new dimension to the exploration of the Big Bang. In short, according to this hypothesis, there may have been two of them, going off one after the other, producing two very different results that gave us the universe we have today, the effect of one Big Bang and the shadow effect of the second. In a paper by Freese and Winkler, link in the description below, they outline the concept of nothing less than a later, dark Big Bang in addition to the normal one. The current general consensus in cosmology is that a sliver of a fraction of time after the universe began, it went into a period of cosmic inflation. Here, the universe's expansion exceeded the speed of light, driven by vacuum energy, and rules a bit different from what we see today. This period, lasting significantly less than a single second, expanded the universe from the size of a subatomic particle to the size of a small town. When this ended, the energy driving the expansion of the universe calmed down, or changed form, allowing for normal matter to begin forming. This ultimately is the Big Bang, the transition from inflation to a place of immense density and heat, a big plasma. But how does dark matter fit into this? If it's some kind of weakly interacting particle, like a wimp, it may fit naturally into that mix, or it may not. Whatever it was, the gravitational anomalies show that dark matter needs to be the dominant form of matter in the universe, like 5 times more abundant than normal matter. Trouble is, its gravitational effects are the only indicators of its existence. It interacts apparently in no other way. The main working hypothesis right now is that matter and dark matter were created at the same time, and that there were steps involved that governed inflation, such as to produce two different results for matter. But we have no idea if that's correct. It's the equivalent of a hunch, and this new paper offers an alternative. It may be that dark matter and matter are so different that they didn't appear at the same time. In this case, the energy of inflation resulted in regular matter, but not dark matter. That may have been something else. It might be that there were two forms of energy involved. Vacuum energy causes inflation and the formation of matter, but also dark vacuum energy, which then resulted in dark matter and potentially connects it in some way to the dark energy of today. Though this is very speculative and may not be the case. The interesting thing here is that it's not necessary for the effects of vacuum energy and dark vacuum energy to have been converted into particles at exactly the same time. In other words, in the very beginning of the universe, there may have been no dark matter at all for as long as a full month after the beginning of the universe. That's not much in the sense of a universe 13.8 billion years old, but it's actually an immense amount of time for Big Bang cosmology. This leaves us with effectively a second dark Big Bang, where long after matter started condensing after inflation, dark matter started condensing from dark vacuum energy. Whether this will be a non-starter of an idea or a revelation that opens up a completely new aspect of the story of how the universe began is an open question, but in this case, the double Big Bang theory is testable. Current tests to try to detect dark matter are all based on a bet that it might, like the neutrino, occasionally interact in a way other than gravitationally. This is a bad problem, because if it doesn't, then all detection experiments of dark matter will come up with nothing. Because of that possibility, we very well could never answer the question of what dark matter's nature is. It would be the particle we know exists, but cannot ever prove, no matter how advanced we become. Likewise, it may represent the unknowable to all civilizations in the universe. A bad outcome indeed. Permanent unknowables in science are brick walls. But if there really is such a huge gulf between the generation of dark matter and normal matter to the point of two Big Bangs having happened, then it very well could be the case that there is no interaction whatsoever between the two other than through gravity. This would make gravity something very special indeed, to say the least. But here's the thing. If it indeed was dark vacuum energy transitioning to dark matter particles, then that change may have left fingerprints in a telltale way. It would have sent shocks through space-time that might be detectable as gravitational waves. There would then be a potentially detectable background of this event. This is sometimes referred to as a cosmic hum, but that's not that great of an analogy. But some early experiments seem to be showing some kind of hum of this type. Though a lot more study is needed because a number of sources for this kind of hum have been advanced from other more mundane astronomical events. But as further work is done and more measurements taken, certain types of gravitational wave background might indicate and prove the existence of the second dark Big Bang. On the other hand, it can also be that this work will finally provide a breakthrough into understanding dark matter itself in a new way. Not only will we simply have the effects of its gravity to study, but we'd also know where it originated, expanding our pool of information such that we might be able to get a handle on what it actually is, especially if it's a weakly interacting particle. But even if we can't ever directly detect it, these two lines of evidence might explain it anyway. One oddity here is that we have a clear bias in this whole thing. We call normal matter, despite it being only about 5% of the makeup of the universe. Dark matter is 27%, and the rest is dark energy. We're actually made up of an abnormal form of matter and energy in this universe. If there was a second Big Bang, then how did that unfold, and why is there so much more dark matter? Well, this may bring antimatter back into the mix. As far as anyone can tell, the Big Bang, as we see it in the standard sense, should have produced equal amounts of matter and antimatter, and they should have annihilated completely. Something about the universe created an asymmetry here. There was slightly more matter than antimatter, leaving a leftover of normal matter. It wouldn't be too surprising then if that leftover matter was simply the remnants of the Great Annihilation, in turn representing such a small fraction of the universe. This may not have happened with dark matter. There are some particles that are their own antiparticle, such as the photon. It may be that dark matter has no charge. In other words, no anti-dark matter. But normal matter does have antiparticles. If you flip the charges of the protons and electrons and atoms from plus to minus or vice versa respectively, they become antimatter. a proton becomes an antiproton, an electron becomes a positron. Dark matter may not have this juxtaposition at all, and is a good candidate for a particle that is, by its nature, its own antiparticle, and thus does not annihilate, meaning that it might become the dominant form of matter in a universe set up this way, with a fundamental difference between normal matter's particles with charges and non-interactive dark matter particles that do not have charges. One type goes through an annihilation, the other doesn't, maybe explaining the ratios. But with the asymmetry of matter and antimatter issue left unsolved, we still have a lot to learn about the universe indeed. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently eyeing the dark matter suspiciously. It really doesn't strike me as dark so much as lazy. So, you want to go out and interact today? Meh, not really. I'll just sit here and make gravity. Very unflattering universe this is, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular, in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.